Hello and welcome to my Model Corner Project 17. In this video, we return to a model ship build and recount the exploits and the tragic fate of the USS Indianapolis. We'll also spruce up the overall detail by adding the Eduard photo etch set created especially for this kit. I'm used to building the 350 scale battleships, and even though this is also in 350 scale, it seems like a 700 scale in comparison. Included is an instruction booklet, decals, and a single-page paint scheme guide. Finally, we have our photo etch set with many pieces. As all ship builds go, we have a lot of work ahead. Better get going.
Where do you think you are? In a pool room?
To start, let's drill out some portholes. I prefer this crisper look that it displays rather than seeing a spot of paint. We have quite a bit of photo etch to add, necessitating modifications of the plastic model itself. This will require somewhat of a multitask strategy in relation to the order of construction and painting steps. Thus, we'll need to go back and forth between the kit instructions and the photo etch instructions. I think the best way to go about this is to build areas where heavy photo etch application is required and then paint and detail each section before general main assembly while trying to maintain continuity in the visual aspects between the different decks and superstructure. After that, we'll add the smaller pieces such as life rafts, anti-aircraft guns, and railed ladders during the final stages of fabrication.
Thank you. torpedo. Bad battle stations torpedo.
Ship bills particularly shine if you can add some photo etch. Especially notable are radar arrays, grid and lattice work of cranes and catapults, and masts, which really enhance the look of a model. Even if there isn't an aftermarket set available for your kit, a generic set of rails, ladders, and watertight doors can much improve detail.
Thank you.
And for the moment of truth, as you can see, the marbling work is especially noticeable on the red portion of the hull, which gives our heavy cruiser a worn, large-scale appearance and a look of realism. We'll do some highlighting, rusting, and some sea salt later on. After we apply the clear coat to most of the parts, we can begin weathering. We'll use the simpler and safer black pastel and water wash to bring out some of the details. We're finally at the point where we can begin major construction. But we missed the spot of deck blue. Let's fix that. Voila! Amazingly, the Eduard photo etch does not include rails. Luckily, I have leftovers from other builds. Let's add some sea salt streaks and hazing using white oil paint, dabbing on a little here and there, then using a wider brush dipped in clean mineral spirits to gently spread it out. I went until it was mostly invisible, and once the mineral spirits evaporated, the streaks and white clouding emerged. The rust is a mixture of yellow and red oil paints, also streaked for effect. Using cyanoacrylate glue and EasyLine, we begin to include the rigging. For our final step, we coat the entire model in dull coat. We're about ready to put this ship on the display shelf. I hope you found this entertaining and informative. Stay tuned after the final reveal for a link to vote for this channel's upcoming projects. If that link has changed, then you've tuned into this video after the polls were closed. Take care, and we'll see you later.